multiplayer playlist, the best place to start with multiplayer in F1 World. This playlist serves up short, fun races. You can either pick a track you want to race at, or you can let the game pick. Once you start to feel comfortable, be sure to check out Ranked Multiplayer for longer, more competitive races and for more reward. try to stay with them, they might make a mistake and we could still regain the position. Front is 2.5 seconds. Okay, well, we didn't hit our target, unfortunately, but the positives are we did keep it clean.
by one other driver, X Senna.
7 seconds. Well done, that's three clean laps in a row. Beautiful stuff, keep it going. Today, and that's good, but we didn't hit our target, did we?
Previously in Breaking Point.
Aidan, please tell us, how does it feel to be on the verge of getting behind the wheel for your very first race?
I feel like a little kid. I look around and I'm surrounded by my heroes.
And tell me about Casper Ackerman. How is that relationship coming along?
It wasn't my fault.
Well, whose fault was it then?
He tried to stop them from signing you. Didn't want to play babysitter. We all feel sorry for you, mate. You never stood a chance with him.
I had a call this week from Christian Horner. You're being watched.
You know what his problem is, don't you? Thinks you're getting too old.
You want respect? You give respect! That's how it works!
How about you give me a little respect?
How about you earn it first?
I'm done.
You what?
I'm retiring.
Why didn't it work out between you two?
He's on more money than me.
What?
He didn't want me on the team.
Didn't I? And you thought I was past my best.
So none of this is true?
There's always gossip in the paddock. And ever since he's arrived, there's been one man at the center of it all. I want us to push for fourth. I want us to beat Butler. And I want that seat to go to you.
So Alfa Romeo potentially on track to really upset AlphaTauri here.
Doing this fight, Crofty.
What about Casper?
Will you let Aidan pass?
Let Aidan pass.
We did it.
We did it.
Have you seen the crash?
Butler's okay?
Bruised ego, perhaps.
What was it like bringing a brand new team to the F1 grid?
You know, the first time you see a car, your car, with your branding, your name on it, in an official race, alongside Ferrari, McLaren, Mercedes, that's what it's all about.
You make it sound like a dream come true.
If only.
When did you first get a sense of what was in store for Connor Sport?
2022 season, straight out of the box. The drivers were always going to clash. That was a calculated risk. But the car. The car had problems.
We're midway through the Miami Grand Prix. It's been a cracking race so far, and it's all up for grabs.
Absolutely, Crofty. Some fantastic driving here today, especially, I have to say, from Aidan Jackson. I don't think I've ever seen the Connor Sport car being put through its paces quite like this.
This is a team, Connor Sport, that have got a lot to prove this season, but Jackson might just be the man to do it.
Okay, Aidan, nice job so far. Let's try and bring that gap down to the car ahead if you can.
Copy that.
move was illegal, I'm afraid, mate. Return the position, give it back. Behind is 10.6 seconds. Brilliant, nice move, keep going. Trailing the car ahead by 5.2 seconds.
the car, please, Aidan. Retire the car.
You're joking!
I'm sorry, Aidan. Pull over now, please. Pull over now.
This is getting ridiculous!
And that's agonising for Jackson. Just a few laps left to go, and he's out of the Miami Grand Prix!
Oh, with every race, the car looks like a constant problem for Connor Sport. It must be devastating for the drivers.
Confirmation as the car comes to a halt that Connor Sport's Aidan Jackson won't be seeing the checkered flag today. But it looks like his teammate will. Jackson's DNF put Devon Butler in a position where he might just be able to secure some points for Connor Sport.
Aidan's out.
Yep, engine problem, I'm afraid.
Good job you got me.
All right, Devon, don't push it too hard. We cannot risk losing both cars here.
It's in the bag, mate.
All okay, Aidan?
Yeah, how's Devon doing?
Yeah, he's doing all right, mate. Looks like he's going to bring home some points for the team.
Good for him.
If it's not one thing, then it's another. Did you not see what happened out there today?
Aidan, I agree with you 100%. We are doing everything we can. I know the car is not perfect, but...
Andreo, it's every race. Do you know how I look losing easy points like this?
Knock, knock. Sounds like there's a riot show going on in here. What am I missing?
Not now, Devon.
Aidan and I were just discussing issues with the car.
Again? I thought that was all in hand. I had no problems today. Smooth. You know what they say? A shoddy workman always blames his tools. mate. You can look at my setup data anytime you want. I've told you that. It might help.
And I've told you before. It's not a setup issue. The problem is...
Jackson, that was the problem with the 2022 season. Ask anyone. I mean, at the end of 21, everyone thought Aidan was going to be signed by one of the big three. But I guess they couldn't reach an agreement, so we both signed for Connor Sport.
And do you think that affected Aidan?
That's no secret. Now, for that 22 season, Jackson was a nightmare.
Aidan, hey, I wanted to give you a heads up. Now look, the crew has shared the latest telemetry data with us.
Fine, but I don't think it'll tell me anything I don't already know.
Just humor me, okay? I'd like to go through it, let me know if anything jumps out. I'm keen to iron out these problems as quickly as possible for you.
Sure thing. Thanks, Andrea.
No thanks needed. I've got your back, Aidan. Remember what I said when you joined the team. I won't let you down. Ackerman won't let me hear the end of it.
Yeah, sounds like Casper. You know he told me the same, right? It's just tricky, what with the car and Devon poking his nose in any chance he gets.
There is a lot going on for sure, but we're a team. We'll get there. I'll have a word with the Devon. Tell him to give you some space, both on and off the track, okay?
Yeah, all right. Good luck with that.
Hey, boss, got a couple of minutes?
Andreo, just going over those last-minute strategy changes you sent over.
Okay.
Yeah, I just want to make it clear, whatever happens out there today, I get pit priority, yeah?
Well, we'll see how the race develops, see? If you need priority, you'll get it. But I can't go into the race with that on the table.
Look, we all know Jackson's not pulling his weight. Now, if you want the points, I need to make sure he's not going to get in my way. Do you get me?
Devon, we've talked about this. Give Aiden some space. It's not about you getting in the way of each other. It's about everyone pulling together, racing as a team.
Of course, yeah. So, pit priority, yeah? All right, ciao.
To turn two we go now. Butler comes out of the pit lane. Jackson is right there with him. This is dicey, Ant. Neither one of these two wants to give way.
This would have been a lot cleaner if Jackson had just let him go. He's just not giving him an inch.
They continue onwards, still wheel to wheel, almost touching there as well, as we head down the straight towards the next chicane. Nothing to separate either car, and through the chicane we go, and now Jackson sends them both off the track and Butler over a curb. That looked nasty.
And I do believe that one of their cars is damaged here, Crofty. I think it's Butler.
Damage, Ant, but also they've lost places too.
Unbelievable and totally unnecessary as well.
Well, one damaged car, places now to make up. What a complete mess that was.
Down. We'll look at it in the debrief later, but right now I want you to go and get those places back. Come on, let's go. Kevin is directly ahead of you now, mate. Down. We'll look at it in the debrief later, but right now I want you to go and get those places back. Come on, let's go. Nice work, mate. That brings you off a place. So we're leading our teammate by 6.5 seconds. Remaining. flag. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. And some information on Leclerc. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car. Green flag. Okay, good work. Great pass. Please, we don't want to lose places because of a penalty. Behind is 36.3 seconds. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining.
Drama here at the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve today. But Ant, what stood out for you?
Well, it must be the Konnersport moment between the two drivers there. Banging wheels, not giving each other room on track. It was entertaining, of course, but definitely for all the reasons.
Yeah, we enjoyed it, certainly. And Aidan Jackson, well, he'd have enjoyed the result. He did well to recover.
He did do well to recover, but, you know, you never want to see two cars, if you're the team boss, seeing two cars hit each other. It's rule number one, don't hit your teammate.
Given all the problems they've had this season, though, getting one car over the finish line, that's probably a big result for them today.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One.
Aiden, just a heads up. We're putting the debrief back by 30 minutes.
Okay, thanks for letting me know.
Listen, while I've got you on, what happened out there today?
It wasn't my fault. Devon thinks he's the only one driving.
I don't want to dwell on it too much at the meeting, but this is not how you run a team. You know this.
Of course. It's just...
No, I don't want to hear it. We have enough problems as it is. Whatever has gone on between you two in the past, I need you to put it to bed.
Sure.
I don't want to have to talk to you like this, Aiden, and I'll be saying the same to Devon. Come on now.
Sure.
See you at the debrief.
Hey there, can you raise that lamp about 6 inches, right? Excellent. A butler should always look sharp. So.
At what point in the 22 season was it clear to you that the team was struggling?
Oh, well, right after the Hungarian GP. I may only be the money, but even to me, it was obvious. The whole thing was a sham.
Yet again, Connor Sport, Jackson and Butler battling it out on track. It seems as
Hang on, 2 seconds, Nat.
OK, Devon, Aiden's lapping faster than you. I need you to let him pass, please. Devon, do you copy? Listen to me, I need you to let Aiden pass now.
Butler just completely blanking the order there. Seems like he didn't even acknowledge it.
Too true, but as you can see, no way through for Jackson. No way at all. This Connor Sport rivalry is getting heated on the track here in Hungary.
We'll be right back.
Nice move. Good job. Us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, we've lost a position, that's us down a place. So the gap to the car ahead, 4.2 seconds. okay. We've got 4 laps of fuel remaining. Drivers just moved into first place. Seconds a lap. Really good stuff. car in front is 3.6 seconds. Okay, so the gap to the car behind is 1.8 seconds. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
So, Nats, who else out there deserves a mention today?
Well, I feel like there are a couple, but let's start with Aidan Jackson.
Couldn't agree more. Jackson had a brilliant race, didn't he?
Yeah, we know Konnersport has struggled all season. Jackson's done really well today, and that's in spite of the problems with his own teammate.
Before they became teammates, these two had their fair share of run-ins. It's a fascinating rivalry. You can't take your eyes off it for one moment. But nonetheless, some much-needed points today for Konnersport. Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should...
Well, a good race out there again today, Aidan. But what we do all want to know, what exactly happened with Devon? It sounded like he completely ignored a direct team order.
I've no clue about that, Natalie. We're completely different strategies. That'd be for Devon to answer. I'm just focused on what I need to do.
Well, he did certainly seem to cause you some trouble out there today. And after that and what happened in Canada... What would you say to those wondering if the old Jackson-Butler rivalry is well and truly back?
No, that's in the past, definitely. We're in the same team now. That's what matters. If there's anything that happens between me and Devon on track, it's because we're so focused on making Konnersport a success. We're bound to tread on each other's toes from time to time.
So, issues with Devon aside, how do you feel it went out there today? Do you think the team will be pleased with your performance?
Could I have pushed it harder? Probably. It was a good enough result, but, you know, with the past issues of the car, I feel maybe we held back a little bit. I'll definitely be putting in the work for the next race weekend, for sure.
So, you mentioned the car there. In that regard, Konnersport's not had the easiest of times so far this season. Has that all been sorted? Are those reliability concerns well and truly behind you?
I hope so. I mean, today was good, yeah. There was no issues with the car. It's always difficult when a driver brings everything they've got and the car lets them down at the last minute. But, you know, I've been told the team has got it all under control, so... Yeah, we'll see what happens in the next few races.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.
Okay, I leave that in your capable hands. Devon, you had a problem with a team order today?
Didn't happen.
What?
Look, I know everyone's saying I ignored it, but it didn't happen. I never got the order. Check the comms.
Shoddy workman always blames his tools, eh?
Check the comms.
Okay, we check the communication pipeline. Fix it. This cannot happen again.
Typical.
Aidan, listen.
What's the point?
It's just Devon being Devon.
And what? That makes it okay? He's an arrogant...
No, you're right to call him out. But imagine if we didn't give him certain freedoms. He'd be even harder to manage. As his father, I know. Aidan. You're the best driver that we have. And it's right for you to put Devon in his place. He needs it. The team needs it.
Thanks. between you and me, I don't think this team is right for me. I think...
Honestly, we don't deserve you. And I know that you've been discussed at other teams, so just keep doing what you're doing.
Sure. I'm sorry if I've spoken out of turn. About Devon?
Not at all. You know the best way to keep Devon in his place?
What's that?
Beat him.
Could you take a look at this, please?
Davidov.
So, I had a word with Aiden.
And?
Nothing to worry about. Don't think there'll be any more problems.
What did you say?
Doesn't matter. We level with each other. Just leave Aiden to me from now on.
And what about Devon?
What about Devon?
We both know it wasn't the comms, right?
Andrea, listen. Devon may push his luck from time to time, but I won't have his integrity questioned. If he says it was the comms, then you know what to do. Yes?
Right. Sure. I'll have them checked again.
See that you do.